Do you want to hear the truth? You want to know what they really feel about you? They see you as a competition. They see you as somebody to take their job one day. Even the same jobs that y'all on, the managers, Deep down within themselves, they see something in you that they don't see in themselves. Deep down within themselves, they wish they were you. You see those little things you say you don't like about yourself and you have a problem with about yourself? Yeah. Those are the things that they envy about you. So when they start showing you the signs, right? They copy you and they mimic your outfit. They mimic the things you say. They mimic the way you walk. And you think it's flattery. No, it's jealousy. Jealous people will kill you. Jealous people can kill you. Wait on God and he will replace
you. You don't want God involved. Don't ask me. Don't ask. Don't ask my advice. Don't ask my opinion. Because I'm going to mention God. I am. I'm going to do that.
External stimuli as well. And finally, they themselves do not reproduce. And at every level of energy
transfer. Jesus, where you at, my boy? Where you at?
And then you come in here and you treat this like a joke. You come in here and look at that and say, I can't read that. You read 10 times better than half of those girls over there.
You did.
And you come in here with a defeatist attitude. I don't have a bad attitude. Maybe I am angry inside. I've been through stuff, so I'm angry.
Yes, but it's not, this is not, be quiet, Tiffany. Be quiet!
That's what is wrong with you.
Stop it!
I have never in my life yelled at a girl like this.
When I first started on this journey, people were like, oh, you pray now. People thought it was funny. Oh, you holy now. Let's see where that gets you. I've learned that we have to wait for stuff. You value it more. When it becomes impossible, and then God does it, he gets the glory. When you've been praying so long, and people been laughing at you, when I had to walk off my job, six-figure income, people laughed at me and they were like, what are you gonna do? The VA not gonna let you come back. VA, I'm not coming back. My daddy got me. My daddy got me.
Oh Lord, oh Jesus.
Hey Jesus.
Hey my friend.
So your God?
Yes, my friend.
And there's only one God.
Yep.
But there's you,
mm-hmm.
God the Father, and God the Holy Spirit.
Yep.
You see where I'm going with this, Jesus?
Mm-hmm.
How can there be one God when you guys are clearly three different beings?
Doesn't seem possible, does it?
No, it doesn't make sense.
1 + 1 + 1 = 3, Jesus.
Yes, and I appreciate the quick maths check.
Yes, three ones do make three, but that could change depending on the context.
Huh?
1 + 1 + 1 = 3, but 1 × 1 × 1 = 1.
Changing the context of the equation reveals a totally different answer, right?
A similar principle is taking place when the scripture says God is one.
How?
The Bible says man and woman, plural, shall come together and be one flesh, singular. Sometimes the Bible refers to the people, plural, being one, singular.
Right.
It's in a context similar to this when the Bible declares the Lord our God is one.
So you're all God.
Children, are you listening? Are you looking for me to come and rule the world 1,000 years and make it into what I wanted it to be? Too many of you today want to go back. You're like Israel. You want to go back to Egypt for the onion, the garlics, and the leeks. You want what you had, but I want you to want me and what I will bring with me when I come. If you plan to make it, You must get your eyes off the world and quit praying for things to go back the way they were. I tell you today, they are not going back. It's going to get darker. People are going to get meaner as evil grows in the earth. You're already seeing it that people are killing people for no reason at all, and it's going to get worse. Just wait until the world experiences my judgment that I pour out. You've seen nothing yet. Those who are not near me and in me will not make it. They will not survive it. Already the enemy has deceived many and multitudes of people. They are deceived. Man cannot save you.
Please stop scrolling. I want to share with you two Bible verses that are going to help you if you're ever feeling worried. Go ahead and share this video, save this video, or just listen to this video. I believe that God wants to speak to you through this. 1 Peter 5:7 says this, "Give all your worries to him because he cares about you." John 14:1 says, Jesus said, "Don't let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God and trust in me." Friend, you can trust in God. If you right now are feeling overwhelmed, worried, or anxious, there is an invitation for you to come to God. And in his presence, you will find the comfort, the peace, and the answers that you have been looking for. Come to God. And I-